Meta just released Llama 3.1, its most advanced open source AI model. And in this video, we're going to review the key features and we're going to keep it simple, non-technical. You don't need to be a software engineer to win with AI. And if you're into that, if you want to win with AI, if you don't want to get too technical, if you want to have fun, now's the time to subscribe. All right, we're going to start with this post from Zuckerberg today.
Hey, everyone. We got another big AI release today. First, Meta AI is on track to reach our goal of becoming the most used AI assistant in the world by the end of the year.
Just by the way, this is part of the advantage of owning some of the most popular platforms in the world. ChatGPT, when it came out, there's no platform. There's no Facebook. There's no Instagram. There's no Threads. That is part of the advantage. And frankly, you have been using Llama. If you use Facebook and Instagram, you've been using Llama. You just don't know it. Anytime you're going into search, anytime you're using any of those features, you're using the AI. So at any rate, I don't want to bang it. I'm just going to say, hey, when you've got a platform, when you have distribution, it's a huge advantage. And quite frankly, I hope you use this for good. Let's keep going.
There are hundreds of millions of people using it already, and we keep making it smarter and freely available in more countries. Today, we're upgrading Meta AI with our newest model, Llama 3.1, which will also be the first open source model at the frontier and among the most advanced out there.
And by the way, I think that's an incredibly important point. The fact that this platform is open source is incredibly important to me. It's going to enhance collaboration with other companies. It's going to increase the transparency and trust. This is one of the problems that a lot of people have with tech, including myself, is that we don't know what's going on behind the scenes. We don't know the algorithm. We don't know what's going on with the voting machines. We don't know this. We don't know that. What I do want is transparency. And so when you open source the code, when you release the code, when it's open source, it makes it much more transparent. The other advantages of open source, it's customizable, infinitely customizable. You're not just using your internal software engineers. The entire world has access. So, you know, if you're a business owner, whoever you are, you're going to be able to create your own customized open sourced platforms and agents. You're going to be able to sell them and share them with others. It's going to explode the productivity of AI. And the other huge advantage is cost efficiency. It's just going to be much less expensive to develop these models, but that's not just the end. Let's keep going.
It's a really big improvement. Smarter, supports more languages, better reasoning, just better overall. I'm going to go deeper on Llama 3.1 in just a minute. But over the next couple of weeks, we're also adding a couple new features. Meta AI's Imagine feature that generates images fast as you type will also let you put yourself in your images in any style and doing almost anything that you can think of. So I think that's going to be quite a bit of fun.
That sounds amazing, by the way. If you have not played with image generation with AI, it's incredibly fun. It's incredibly awesome. And Midjourney, ChatGPT, the Imagine feature, I really like this ability that as I'm typing, it's going to continuously change the way that the image looks. It's going to be a lot of fun. Also, kind of terrifying when it comes to deep fakes and what's real and what's fake, but I think it's pretty cool.
We're also getting closer to releasing a tool that you can use to create your own AIs to interact with across our apps, so more on that soon. Now, for more details on Llama 3.1, we're releasing by far the most advanced open source model at 405 billion parameters. It's got 88.6 MMLU and some state-of-the-art benchmarks ahead of any closed model on math, reasoning, tool use, and long context. It's a big deal. It's going to be more affordable to run than similar closed models. And because it's open, you're going to be able to use it to fine-tune, distill, and train your own models of any size that you want.
So here on this channel, I like to keep things simple. You don't need to be a software engineer. You don't need to be some sort of MIT technical graduate to actually benefit. So I like to keep things simple. So thanks for subbing and liking this video if that's important to you. But what's really important about having this 405 billion parameter model is it's going to better contextualize. It's going to better understand text generation. It's going to reduce hallucinations and that sort of thing. So improving the accuracy, improving the performance is incredibly, incredibly important. If you've leveraged AI in the past and asked something like ChatGPT to generate text for you, sometimes it can just give you these wonky examples or it can kind of lose itself when it's halfway through the text. Well, the more parameters, the more context, the better it's going to perform. So just as a quick understanding, just to understand, here's the deal. 405 billion parameters means it's going to be a heck of a lot more accurate, and it's going to give you a much better final product, which I think is important. As a business owner, by the way, I'm constantly looking for ways I can use AI to give my prospects and customers a better experience. And at this point, I believe the best usage for AI is to empower myself and my team. But it just, it's, I don't think it's ready to just directly send answers and information and AI generated responses to prospects and clients. It's not there yet. It's not there yet. But the more parameters, the closer we're going to get to that. So stay tuned. I'll let you know what I find out as I find it out.
We're also releasing updated 70 billion and 8 billion parameter models that we've distilled from the 405. And those are now the leading open source models for their sizes. I think that open source AI is going to become the industry standard, just like Linux did. It gives you control to customize and run your own models. You don't have to send your data to another company, and it's more affordable. I also think that the transparency and scrutiny are going to make open source AI safer and more secure, just like other open source software. We've done rigorous testing on all of our models, and of course, since they're open, everyone can do their own testing as well.
So, kind of mirroring what I had mentioned a moment ago in the advantage of open source, but the other thing that he kind of just briefly glanced over is that the different models, the synthetic data generation and model distillation. And I know what you're thinking, Mark, it sounds like you're speaking another language. I don't know what you're talking about. Generation this, synthetic that, distillation that. So basically what he's saying is that what Llama 3.1 is going to be able to do, it's going to be able to take all this data, all these parameters, and create additional data to train a new models. We're moving into this phase of humanity where every company is trying to develop these large language models, these LLMs. And you may have heard this before. Hey, how did you train your LLM? How did you train your model? Is it based on private information, sensitive customer information? Are you basing it off of YouTube videos? Are you basing it off of Reddit? How are you developing your models? And what Zuck is saying here is that they're going to be able to use the data to create new data sets. And I don't, quite frankly, I don't know exactly how this is going to roll out. But what do I know as an average human being? As an average human being who's trying to make it in this new world, who's trying to just really thrive in this AI world, being able to program your own AI agents, being able to program your own AI software without being some sort of tech guru is going to become incredibly, incredibly, incredibly important. And you can already do it to an extent, but this advancement is going to take us a step further. And I'm going to give you a quick example of how this plays out. I was speaking with a client, with a colleague earlier today. I speak to a lot of people in the AI world, and I bring my best stuff here to you. So he's working with this community, and he wants to build a chatbot to answer questions for everyone in the community, right? Like, there's only one leader. How do I serve all the members of my community and give them quick answers? Well, what he's doing is he's training a chat bot, and he's just creating lots and lots of mega prompts. He's developing the API. He's using ChatGPT to do this, or the OpenAI from ChatGPT. And he's uploading PDFs, standard operating procedures. He even uploaded a copy of the NIV Bible. And why am I telling you this? I'm telling you this because as we move forward with open source material, with these large language models, where we're going is we're going to be building our own AI chatbots, our own AI agents, our own AI assistants to make our lives easier. That's what AI is going to be doing. You don't want to answer your phone? Your AI agent will answer the phone call. And then we're going to have AI agents talking to AI agents, right? But where I'm going with this is a big step in the right direction when it comes to one of the most important skills you can learn in the coming days, weeks, months, years, which is how do I empower myself with AI and how do I train AI to give me a better result? And so what he's saying here with this advanced capability through synthetic data generation and advanced model distillation, it's going to help you. You're going to be able to create your own data sets and train your own models much more easily. All right, let's get back to Zuck.
Partnering with a lot of companies to make it easier for everyone to use Llama. AWS and Databricks are launching services for fine-tuning and distilling your own models. NVIDIA supports fine-tuning and synthetic data generation with their AI Foundry. Grok has built low-latency inference. Scale.ai and Accenture are working with enterprises to adopt Llama. And of course, you're going to be able to access the models on all of the major clouds, including AWS, Azure, Google, and Oracle. If you want to go deeper, I just posted a letter on Threads on why I believe that open source is the path forward. So go check it out. Check out the upgraded Meta AI and let me know what you think.
So to summarize, this is a big deal. This is a big deal. And again, you might not even recognize it in your daily life today, but as you're using different softwares like AWS, like Meta, like all the Meta platforms, Facebook, Instagram, you're going to be using this AI. It's going to give you a better experience. But more so, I think what's really important is setting this basis of being open source, of building trust with users, of you and me and your employees and your team and your family and your church being more empowered to create your own AI agents. They're going to be more accurate. It's going to be much less expensive to create them. And they're going to be, it's going to completely change the world. You know, we're going to, the next billion-dollar company is going to be one person supported by lots of AI agents. Maybe not the next one, but that is coming soon. So anyway, let's break down these key features again and wrap a bow on this puppy. Thank you for liking, subscribing. Leave a comment below if you found this interesting. So let's kind of summarize this, right? Meta introduced Llama 3.1. It's live. You can use it. It's on Facebook. It's on Instagram. It's on Threads today. You can use it. It's going to feature a 405 billion parameter, which is going to give it a better understanding and generation of text. It's going to improve accuracy and performance. It's going to support longer context lengths up to 128 kilobytes. Llama 3.1 supports longer context lengths up to 8 different languages. It's going to have enhanced coherence and context throughout writing. It's going to reduce your hallucinations. It's going to give you advanced capabilities in synthetic data generation and model distillation, which, as we talked about before, is going to make it much easier for you to transfer knowledge from one large language model to another. Essentially, you're going to be able to create your own AI platforms and bots much more cost-effectively. It's going to aim to empower developers with tools for custom agents and workflows. And in the future, everyone's going to have their own custom agents, probably many, many agents. I would say within the next 10 years, there are going to be way more AI agents than there are human beings. There's 8 billion human beings in the world. Bold prediction, in 10 years, there's going to be 16 billion AI agents that are all working in tandem. There's going to be enhanced safety and security tools that are included. We'll see how that rolls out. Is this just lip service? Is this just kind of that responsible talk? I think the fact that it's open source is a big deal and goes a long way towards that. And the model's openness and partnering with major tech firms is going to help us to foster the innovation and develop this much, much faster. I don't know about you, but I am over the moon excited with what's coming in AI, how it's going to empower me, my business, my clients, my family, my community. It's going to be freaking amazing, but you need to learn it. You need to be jumping in right now. By subscribing and liking this video, it puts you a long way there. You can also subscribe to my newsletter at AIUpdate.ai. That's AIUpdate.ai. Get in the win. Get in the news. I'll see you in the next video. All right. Peace.